Windows Phone 7.5, that's Mango, has apparently now been finished and sent off to, quote, manufacturing, which means manufacturers can start building it into new devices, as we'll see in a moment. It also means that once the various companies have finished their testing, we should be seeing Mango updates for all our existing Windows Phone phones. Watch this space, Mango is a very big update indeed. In case you're wondering, the next few versions of Windows Phone are Tango and Apollo in 2012 and 2013, respectively. Fujitsu and Toshiba have clubbed together to launch the first official Windows Phone Mango from day one device, the IS-12T. It'll launch in Japan first and is ruggedized, being waterproof and dustproof, and it's apparently got a 13 megapixel camera, plus the other usual specs, including 32 gigabytes of mass memory. Possibly a tech bargain for those in the know, the ancient but always impressive, hardware-wise, Sony Ericsson Xperia X10 is apparently about to get Android 2.3 Gingerbread, this for the device that was stuck on Android 1.6 for a year. With a gorgeous 4-inch transflective screen, suddenly grabbing one of these for 80 quid on eBay seems a great little upgrade project for a rainy day. You'll remember I talked about unique selling points in the last phone show. Into a competitive world of high-end Android Touch Labs comes HTC's latest and greatest, the Sensation. It really is HTC's best device in this category ever, and its unique selling point compared to the competitors, the Samsung Galaxy S2, the LG Optimus 2X and the Motorola Atrix, is that it runs HTC Sense. More than a front-end or launcher, there are myriad little touches and extra apps throughout the OS that you're either going to love or hate. Either way, though, at least it's different. In terms of raw hardware, its HTC look, feel and components just amped up a little from what we've seen on their smaller Desire S, etc. The display's 4.3 inches now and QHD resolution, one of the first Android phones to go up to this, 540 by 960 pixels. And it's a true 16:9 ratio, like most of the Nokia smartphones, meaning that it's easier to use one hand in the hand, and that media playback is more natural in landscape mode. There's some bad news on the hardware side, though, I'm afraid. For starters, the display tech used is still Super LCD, though there's not much super about it when compared to Samsung's Super AMOLED Plus or Nokia's clear black display. The Sensation isn't quite as impressive indoors, and it's much harder to read outdoors. I guess Samsung snaffled all those top-end AMOLED displays for themselves. Secondly, the Sensation uses this insane assembly method whereby the phone's aerials are in the back cover, top and bottom here, meaning that there has to be a way to connect the cover to the innards. Enter sets of spring-loaded gold contacts here. Now, I've had some experience of this method of connection and phones. I've had major hassles with the sprung contacts on the Nokia N86, for example, for its FM transmitter, which is always cutting out, very annoying. And here we have no fewer than 6 sprung pings handling 4 electrical contacts, all in a frame which isn't really 100% rock solid on itself. See if you can hear the creaking here if I hold it up near the microphone. I'm sorry, but RF aerials have to be hardwired, and this system's going to cause problems as the device gets older. Thirdly, the speaker. Oh dear. I heard that HTC had bumped up the speaker for the Sensation, but they haven't by much. It's basically the same old tinny rubbish. This is maximum volume. Horrible for podcasts and barely bearable for video soundtracks. But enough ranting. The specs are high enough. 1.2 gigahertz dual-core Scorpion CPUs, plus a GPU, that's a graphics acceleration chip, 768 megabytes of RAM, 1 gigabyte of storage for apps internally, plus micro SD expansion, with an 8 gigabyte card supplied. The camera is now 8 megapixels and better than any other HTC phone I've ever used, which isn't saying a lot. But here are some samples. Video, impressively, is up at 1080p, though you're rather limited by the quality of the optics here and the sensor. Here's a sample. And this is a test of the HTC Sensation's video quality in strong UK sunshine. There's pre-focusing. Let's see what you think of the audio quality. There is HDMI out, but you'll have to buy a standard MHL to HDMI adapter. There isn't one in the box. General connectivity is good, gold contacts notwithstanding, With slick DLNA support over Wi-Fi to your home media equipment with Wi-Fi, GPS, and the other 2011 usuals. Android 2.3 here and HTC Sense 3 is a pretty complete software package, even if that also means there are two of some things and that we get the HTC apps rather than Google's versions, for example, HTC's Wi-Fi hotspot utility. Android does work very well on the QHD screen, and the sheer size of it meant that even I wasn't struggling to read text. In this regard, the Sensation is a great package. And when you need the resolution, such as in the web browser, the QHD screen is wide enough to show web pages as is, with no need to zoom out to fit them all in. The limit here is probably your own eyesight. Social networking is attempted with the huge and limited FriendStream widget, but thankfully this is tied in with your login details for Peep, the built-in Twitter client, and this latter isn't all bad. Though why HTC have decided to reinvent the wheel given official clients for both Facebook and Twitter isn't entirely clear. HTC have replaced Google's Contacts app with its own People client, integrating the Google original Contacts store with HTC Sense Contacts, Facebook Contacts, and Twitter Contacts. They're all in one place here. While Polaris Office offers file editing and creation with only a few compatibility issues, and most other applications are recognizable standard Android that you know and probably love. YouTube, Market, Navigation, and so on. Music playback is rather let down by the nasty headphones supplied. Why do HTC do everything on the cheap? But plug in a decent headset via the 3.5mm socket and you're off and rocking. Multimedia playback is decent and most videos in most formats I tried played, with the widescreen display really coming into its own, only let down really by the titchy speaker. New for the Sensation is HTC Watch, an online movie store where you can choose from up to 500 movies at exorbitant prices for progressively downloading, i.e. you start watching immediately and then it sort of catches up in the background, or on up to four other HTC phones or tablets on which you're signed into the system, but it is DRM'd. It's slick enough, and I get it that it might save the day when stuck in a hotel room or waiting room, but personally, I'd rather have the DVD or Blu-ray and deal with the content transfer myself, or just source material in a myriad of other ways online. But the star of the show is ultimately HTC Sense 3, which in addition to putting its tendrils into many parts of Android and its settings, also provides a truly vast amount of configurability. Truly no two people's sensations ever need to have the same front end that looks the same. And did you spot the 3D-like carousel effect as you slide between your customized home screens? Oh, and the customizable lock screen app launcher? Just drag the app of your choice into the lock arc. As I said on the Desire Z, HTC Sense means you've always got something to fiddle with, something to tweak, something to play with on a rainy day. It's geek heaven. Is Sense enough, though? If you take away the Sense fiddleability blanket, you've got a tablet smartphone that's outgunned at almost every turn by the Samsung Galaxy S2, which has got better screen, better camera, better speakers, cellular aerials, which are at least glued in place, more solid hardware, faster OS, though the Sensation does just win on raw screen resolution for big web and media users. But the Sensation, as the name perhaps implies, is mainly for Sense fans. This is by far the best HTC Sense smartphone yet. It's just not as good as the wider class of 2011 Android competition.